This Congress has championed the unwinding of campaign finance laws to give billionaires outside influence over our politics. Systematically attacked voting rights to make it harder for young people and minorities and the poor to vote. Embraced wild conspiracy theories like those surrounding Benghazi.
Former President Obama slamming GOP lawmakers over what he says is their obsession with the Benghazi attack, calling it a wild conspiracy theory. And that's not sitting well with a lot of folks, particularly those who were there that horrific night. Joining us now is one of the members of the Benghazi annex security team, John Tiegen, who ran toward the consulate as it burned. John, good morning, and thank you for coming on the program this morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
How did the former president's comments there sit with you?
You know, it's really not shocking coming from them, because it's just, it's what they've been doing the whole time. They try to deflect, they try to rewrite everything to make sure it fits their agenda. You know, it's definitely a reckless and very disrespectful to the family members. You know, if you don't, everybody remembers, you know, they lied to them on the tarmac because their bodies were being brought home about the attack, what happened, why it happened. But again, if it's a conspiracy of what happened there, once you go and ask the family members, you know, how Ron and them feel, because, you know, they obviously can't tell you exactly how they feel, because it's not a conspiracy. What happened is what happened. And, you know, the only conspiracy really behind it was their deflection of trying to say it was a protest and over a video. That's where the conspiracy's from.
Well, the comments surely, as we can hear, did not sit well with you. They did not sit well with the former Congressman Jason Chaffetz, who suggested that this is the former president, Barack Obama, attempting to rewrite history. Watch.
It was President Obama that took the United States into war with Libya. And in an interview with Chris Wallace on Fox News, President Obama said the worst mistake of his presidency was dealing with the aftermath of Libya. Nobody on the campaign trail brought this up except President Obama, and he is fundamentally and totally and wholly wrong. And people like Tonto and Tig and these people who put their lives in line and saved dozens of people, shame on the president for saying that.
And of course, he is referencing Chris Tonto Pronto, one of the heroes from that night who watched his friends die. He called the comments from the former president disgusting. Just wanted to get your reaction to that.
I mean, it is totally disgusting. I mean, we sat there, you know, for 8 hours direct contact with an enemy, 13 hours overall, and, you know, we're sitting there waiting for support. I mean, Ambassador Stevens was expecting support, at least some kind of backup. And, you know, they call him his friend, and, you know, they didn't do anything. You know, it's just a lack of leadership and understanding of the situation that was going on over there. They had Marines that were ready to go, make them change in on a uniform 3 times. You know, their leadership is, I mean, I wouldn't call it a leadership. It was totally lack of a leadership, and the comprehension of the situation on the ground. They just didn't have it, or they just didn't even care. You know, Obama's probably more worried about getting reelected than helping us. And the same with Hillary Clinton. She was more worried about her next run, when she was going to run for office once he was done. It's just, you know, they have just total disrespect. And it's, again, it's another smack in the face to everything that we did over there. And they're just trying to deflect what truly happened to make themselves look good.
Well, and here we are 6 years later. 17 years after 9/11, we've been honoring the fallen and those who fight on our battlefields this morning in the aftermath of 9/11. And here we are 6 years after the attacks in Benghazi also took place on September 11th. If you could, as we look at those 4 fallen Americans, could you look back for us 6 years later and your thoughts today, John?
You know, my thoughts on it is just, you know, we got to pick up and move forward. Can't really dwell on the past and what really happened. You know, just by honoring the guys who did fall, you keep pushing forward. You never quit. And, you know, you carry on the load. You carry what those couldn't do, and you just move forward. I mean, that's the biggest thing. And I know Rowan above, they want us to do the same thing. Just never quit. Just pick up and move on.
It's such a powerful message coming from someone like you. Who was right there. What is your message? How do you move forward?
You move forward by honoring those guys that did fall. I mean, I'm not going to quit, because to me quitting would totally dishonor the guys that gave their lives for the rest of us. And that's what I do. You know, I push forward with my foundation Beyond the Battlefield, helping veterans. And, you know, that's my biggest thing. I just always want to help others and do what's best.
Well, thank you for what you did. Thank you for what you do. And thanks for being on the program this morning.